Shalom. So today we're going to be making minced garlic. Excuse the little doobie because garlic can get into your hair and all that. I mean, I already cleaned it. These are for my hair. I don't need my hair getting into all this. So it's bound up. But today, I got my little helper today. He's a camera guy. Got to work on his camera skills, but he's getting there. I have several heads of some of the hard neck garlic that I was telling you guys about. Some soft neck that doesn't have a stem. You can see in here. And we're going to be doing the usual, breaking it up. I think you're going to see if those who have strong hands. Just break up the garlic, break them to pieces. Usually I'll make my minced garlic out of the smaller ones that you see here versus the larger cloves. But since I already planted some of these, I'm just going to use them the whole entire thing. Don't shake the camera, brother.
Sorry, my ear is itchy.
Okay. So, oh my gosh.
Sorry, my ear is itchy, guy.
Okay. So we're going to be cracking these open. The skins, we pretty much toss them into the garden, let them over winter, let them be like the leaves, and it also gives some nutrients to it. We're going to be adding a little bit of our
pink
Himalayan salt and some oil. I haven't chosen what oil I'm going to use, either olive oil or grapeseed or avocado. I'm not sure quite yet which one I'm going to use, but I'm going to be using that. We're going to put them in our food processor. Tell them I keep the camera still.
Sorry, yeah, I don't know how to keep the camera still.
Put it in the food processor and then add the ingredients that you see here and then put it in this jar. This will be a short, straight, and to the point video today. I just wanted to sit there and add that some people may find the smashing this too much for their hands or even just to individually peel all these skins off. So some people may find it easy to actually take a bigger mason jar or a jar as this and actually just break this open and put all the cloves inside of it. And then what they will sit there and do is pretty much put these cloves, put the lid back on, and pretty much just roughly just shake it, and then pour them back out. And then sometimes just doing that alone will make that hack a little bit easier for their peeling. So for those who may have tried to make their own garlic or want to make their own garlic, put your comment down below. And pretty much let me know if that hack works for you.
So we're back. Again, so I'm gonna put these garlic cloves in the jar and I'm gonna shake them as fast as I can.
To help you do what?
To help to get the skins off.
Okay. We're gonna try that hack.
And then I'm gonna put the lid on it and shake them up.
Go ahead.
So the skins can come off. That's another way besides crushing them.
Oh, I thought you said skins. Yes, the skins. Okay. Sorry, but go ahead, put the top on.
So we're gonna put the top on.
Good.
Right now, see, put the top on.
Twist it real tight. Show the jar to them. Show it to them.
You see it? You see all the skins?
Now open it up. Pour them out. And now take off the and show it to them.
And you see this one has skins. This one had skins, but now it's off. Well, most of them are off. Just like this one, I don't feel no skins on this one. See?
So peace and healings, family. So we are done peeling all our garlic. When I first made the minced garlic, it fit into one of these. So our goal this time is to make it fit into one of these jars. So roughly, it may end up getting this full, may have some left over. So I may end up using this jar again or my 4-ounce jar. And we're also thinking about making another variation of having it herbed minced garlic, where we actually use dried rosemary or Italian season, something that we normally would put in to mix with our garlic. So we're going to be putting these inside of our food processor. It's like an oysterizer. My mother had it since forever.
Mm-hmm.
It pretty much just locks in, put it in there.
And we're going to blend it.
And we're going to pulsate it more so.
Yeah.
So we're going to put it in there.
Okay.
We're doing that. He's going to be doing the blending. So we got that going.
I'm a big boy.
Okay.
I'm a big boy.
So we got that filled up. a little bit too full. Take some of these out. Yep, so we got it really full. And what we're going to sit there and do is we're going to crush them down a little bit low and try to get them as minced as we can. Mm-hmm. If we got to do it twice, we got to do it twice. And then we're going to add, show me a teaspoon.
Just salt. We got to use the salt.
We're going to start with that. We normally don't go more than a teaspoon of salt. And then we're going to be using our avocado. So we got a little bit left. So if I need to add any more, if it gets too dry, I got more up there where you see the scallions and the lemongrass growing. Mm-hmm. Add to that. The salt's helping to preserve. Some people do like their minced garlic in water.
That's my tooth.
Their minced garlic in water. However, I haven't dealt with that because I do put it in the fridge. I'm not sure how long my garlic, 1 second, will last if I've actually put it in water versus if I've actually put it in oil. So when I say I need a recipe calls for a tablespoon or 2 cloves of minced garlic, I will scoop some of this into the pot and it'll begin to melt. So obviously make sure you have everything ready when you scoop this in and put it in there. And this will be what we will have shortly.
And then we're going to blend.
Now we're going to add our
Himalayan salt, okay, aka pink salt. Taz is going to be like, he said aka pink salt. That would be cracking up.
More than enough. And when it comes to the oil, as much as you like. Also, if you are into making your home oil, where you pretty much mix this and you mix your herbs the way you want to and cook them.
Avocado oil.
You will literally can add your own variation of oil, meaning like you have this with other herbs, and let's say you want that Italian seasoning or a more spicy kick to your garlic, you can use the cayenne red pepper oil to add to this if you like, etc., etc.
The avocado oil. And I see it's draining it, like it's going down. It's draining it. So we're going to blend it again.
So being that avocado oil and grape oil pretty much have the same properties as far as high heat content, I'm going to add some grape seed oil to it. That should be more than enough.
You see, it was just up there, not sucking it in. It was just up there. Post or nose.
Let's go. So this is pretty much the minced garlic. It's still a little bit soupy, not soupy, but it's pretty much movable. Solely because I had the oil in it. But it's going to end up solidifying, as you see. Tastes good, right amount of kick, right amount of salt. And that was for filling this up. So we're going to be scraping this into the jar. So pretty much this whole full jar of cloves plus a little bit from the top of this made this thus far. Now I can choose to try and blend some more and actually get this, but this is pretty much done. The top was on the table where it was cutting. So this is pretty much our minced garlic, all finished. Short, sweet, and to the point. So being that, it smells amazing. And it actually tastes pretty good. So in this case, you know, a chef should always taste their food.
Can I taste it?
Mm-hmm. Be careful the blade. Very good, very good.
Okay. It does taste good, but kind of spicy.
So,
trying to get that,
you gonna let it, put it in the fridge, and be ready to use it. Open it up, scoop what we need.
Tastes like grits, huh?
And there's your minced garlic. So since we're going to try and do a herbed one, probably going to grind the rest of this up. This may fit into this jar. It may not. It may fit into one of those 12-ounce jars. So I'll save this for a later date to sit there and do an updated video on actually making an herbed one. I'll let you know how that goes. But other than that, sorry about the look. Didn't want to get all garlicky. The baby's going to be getting up soon. But don't forget to like, share, subscribe. Hit the comments down below. Leave whatever you need. Leave a comment if you actually tried the shake method. Leave a comment if you had never thought to make your own minced garlic. Anything in between. And peace and healing. Shalom.